U.S. Senators Bob Menendez and Cory Booker, State Senator and Union City Mayor Brian Stack, and expected new Attorney General of New Jersey Gurbir Grewal were just a few of the dignitaries in attendance for the swearing-in ceremony of new Hoboken Mayor Ravi Bhalla.
Stack, whose Senate district includes Hoboken, reminded Bhalla that he is always just a phone call away.
You know, as Jerry just mentioned, I'm only a phone call away. Whether it's being a fellow mayor, the state senator in Hoboken, I'm just a phone call away, and whatever help I can give to you and the residents of Hoboken, I'll always be there. I'm also very thankful that you had me speak first and not after Senator Booker and Senator Menendez and the prosecutor, how lucky I am not to follow in those footsteps.
Grewal, the Bergen County prosecutor who has been nominated to be the new state AG by Governor-elect Phil Murphy, is a childhood friend of Bhalla who humorously reflected on being mistaken for the new Hoboken mayor.
I was here just about a month ago, about a couple of weeks after Robbie had just won the election, and I had an event at Stevens where I had to speak. I was walking the streets of Hoboken to get to Stevens, and hardly a block went by without somebody stopping me and saying, "Congratulations, mayor." Be their best wishes. So, Robbie, I did what you would do if the roles were reversed and have them in the courthouse in Hackensack, and I played along with it. And so I answered questions about parking on Washington. I committed Robbie to more open space in it while holding the line on taxes.
Menendez said he was thrilled to be in Hoboken, a city that elected the state's first Sikh mayor, a stark contrast to what's happening in Washington, D.C.
And I know that I'm also thrilled to be here today with my colleague, Senator Booker, because when we are in Washington, we hear different voices. And I'm thrilled to be at home, to be in a place like Hoboken, where we reject the politics of division and intolerance and embrace the politics of inclusion and diversity in our lives. Hoboken has produced some incredibly talented people in public service. And I know that Robbie Bhalla is going to even exceed that great vision.
After swearing in Councilman-at-Large James Doyle and newcomers Emily Jabor and Vanessa Falco, the latter being the first African-American councilwoman in Hoboken history, Booker, a rumored 2020 Democratic presidential candidate, spoke about the significance of Bhalla as mayor.
That's why today I am particularly honored and feel the sense of celebration to be here for an important historic moment. I tell you right now, I've gone around this country in the last weeks, from Alabama to Washington to California to home, and everybody seems to be talking about the election of the mayor of this great city. I want to tell you something. This nation is lucky to elect this great man to be its mayor because of this. Two reasons, one personal and then one patriotic. You cannot lead the people if you don't love the people. This is who Robbie is. He has a love for the people. And indeed, that's what patriotism is. Patriotism says love of country, but you cannot love your country unless you love your countrymen and women. And the reason why I say the second reason I'm proud to be here is because of patriotism, is because the founders of this nation understood the importance and the urgencies of love.
After being sworn in, Bhalla reiterated campaign promises of keeping taxes stable, maintaining clean streets, and being Hoboken's infrastructure mayor, further stating that City Hall will be adding an Office of Constituent Services, as well as a task force of first responders assembled to review bar crawls with a bad reputation such as Leprechaun and SantaCon. In closing, the new Mile Square City mayor said he had an infinite respect for his father for refusing to cut his hair or get rid of his turban after starting his college career at Penn State when faced with the cruel choice between your religion and your livelihood, citing former Supreme Court Justice Thurgood Marshall.
His friend said that you need to remove your turban and cut your hair before any of the students see you on campus. Essentially, he was being told that he must make a choice. He must sacrifice his articles of faith in order to succeed in this country. My father made that fateful decision not to do this because when he came to this country to seek the American dream, which to him meant that there was no conflict between how you worship and your ability to succeed, if you work hard in American life. My father resisted that choice that former Supreme Court Justice Thurgood Marshall called, quote, that cruel choice. And Thurgood Marshall used that word cruel. He said that cruel choice between your religion and your livelihood that no American should have to make.
John Hytus with the Hudson County View, the eye of the community.